one of the baby broke out. It's alive. It's moving.
I'm super excited about this, the first ostrich baby that just hatched.
Finally.
So when they hatch, there's an umbilical cord that sometimes, you know, it's that's where they receive their nutrients inside, from inside the egg yolk, and you need to put Neosporin. I mean, maybe they would be okay without it, but it's best to just disinfect a little bit. To just make sure there's no way that it's gonna be infected. You know, they obviously, they survive in nature most of the time, but I bet, like, nature is not 100% proof, and, you know, if they drag their umbilical cord on the ground, it is a possibility. But the nature, they're in very low humidity, like in the desert where they actually live, is very low humidity. So what that does, their hatching, by the time they hatch, they hatch stronger, and they're not gonna be as wet, and the blood eventually dries out from the egg, from the low humidity environment. So they least likely they're gonna have a problem of bleeding. But I tried to use a dehumidifier, and even with the humidifier, it's really challenging to do such a low humidity environment. You know, like average room can be like 30% humidity. You have to get it under 20, at least 20. But I would put the humidity control it under 20%, and that's how you can match those desert environments. And you have to also think about the wind. That outside, the wind dries as it passes by, and sometimes I think the animals get up as well. So that's why it's not the same to incubate as being in the nature. But on the other hand, when you incubate them, they're gonna be less wild. When you have the parents raise them, they're gonna be very much wild. But you also lose less animals when you incubate, because in nature a lot of things can happen, and like sometimes even the mom, the dad who is hatching, so the dad can step on them and kill them, because you know they're super heavy, of course by accident. I mean, it's not typical, but it can very much happen. So you just try to do your best to minimize the danger factors for the animal, and that's why we rather incubate. I was watching a lot of people talking about trying to raise them naturally, and almost everyone says that it didn't work out for them. Like somehow they lost the animals, unfortunately, when they were just trying to raise them naturally, so have the father animal hatch them versus the incubator. So most people, especially who do it for profit, the people who do this for profit, they just go back to incubator because that's the one that works.
Hello.
Ostriches only make these kind of voices when they are young, and eventually they stop making these noises after a few months. And so when they feel danger sometimes, I mean, maybe when they're young, of course, because it changes when they're older. They prefer to just sit down because I took this baby outside. It's regular environment. So it thought it's safer to sit down. But sometimes they're very curious, so you bet they go discovering. One of the surprising facts that I also experienced, that ostriches, after they hatch, they don't eat for 4 or 5 days. And as I mentioned earlier, they have an umbilical cord inside, which they are supplied the nutrients from the egg yolk. And so they store that. And they also have water. When you see the puffy neck, the puffed up neck and the feet, that means they're full of water from what was inside the egg. So they are loaded up and they're not even gonna drink for a few days. But of course, I mean, you can have the water there just for them to have, and especially that we had like a hot summer. So you can have the water next to them, but they're probably not even gonna touch it for the first 2 days or maybe 3 days.
Oh my god, we have 4 babies.
And they're gonna be perfectly fine.
One is already out on the ground, healthy, running around.
The problem is otherwise they can just walk into the water if they give them too much earlier, and they would just plow into the water, and who knows, maybe they would get cold. I mean, you have the heat lamp going, so it should be around 96 degrees, maybe 100, but being wet is not that fun sometimes, and they are not smart enough to realize that.
It's not in front of me. Discover the water. It's the first time I see them drinking.
The very cool thing about this EcoFlow gas generator, that this can be triggered by the EcoFlow Delta 2000 watt battery operated generator, which is actually not a generator, but that can support my incubators in case of a power outage for about 7 hours, or about, 7 hours fully charged. But as soon as the 7 hours would go by, then so that can trigger this gas generator. And I mean, if you have a lot of eggs incubated, this can save you thousands of dollars. Will save you from loss.
Being silly, like eating on the edge. What's the point of eating on the edge? They love to bite the porcelain. This is how silly. Oh, don't fight.
So this is these are my duck eggs in this cheap incubator.
And
surprisingly, it worked. And the temperature is higher, it's about 100 degrees, And right now I'm candling the egg, as you can see. And you can see the air bubble on the top. And I saw some movement earlier. Unfortunately, I wasn't filming, but they were moving. And if you're wondering why the eggs are dirty, yeah, you can clean them, but it has to be disinfectant water containing disinfectant, and it has to be warmer. Otherwise, it can ruin the egg totally. So sometimes it's better not to wash it if you don't know how the right way to
There's
do it.
There's a baby in here.
Again, if the water is colder than the egg, it can go inside the egg. So the water has to be warmer than the egg, a few degrees, in order to not go inside the pores of the egg. Yes, the egg has some pores because it can breathe, and it must be through the pores. And unfortunately, if those pores let bacteria inside, it can create bacterial infection. It usually does like a brown discoloration inside the egg when you open it. That's a sign of a bacterial infection. And that can totally ruin and kill the embryo, unfortunately. Previously, when you saw the 104 degrees, yeah, it's a little bit too high. Unfortunately, the summer can be even hotter than that here. It can be 106, but I had to put them in the garage. That was the highest that it went. I turned on the AC because you want to protect them from predators.
This is where the air bubble is, so yeah, you can only open it from here.
Candling the egg is kind of important because you see where the air bubble is. That's the only place that you can open the egg in case it's way overdue. Because otherwise you would damage the chick if you don't open it from the air bubble. If everything goes well, you should not see a bloody membrane. Unfortunately, this can be a result of high humidity, and it's also called wet chick. When the egg was in the incubator for way too long, I found it better to open, because they don't have enough strength to open the egg. And the another thing that you see, the membrane is sticking to this poor thing. But I used a dehumidifier, but I started kind of late, like maybe a week later or 2 weeks later. So you have to do it like from the beginning, because it was springtime and it was kind of rainy. So unfortunately, the humidity was way higher than it was supposed to be. The humidity should not be more than 20%, but even the 20 can be high. Sometimes maybe I should say 15.
Interesting that they hated the case so much, although it wasn't as hot, and I thought they're hot, but no, it was only just 91 degrees or something, but they hated it. And now it's 104 degrees and it's, you know, they're running around and eating still. I mean, they started sitting down because they got scared, but maybe if it goes any higher, I might have to remove them and take them outside.
This is a tiny duck egg from a smaller breed of duck. And I heard voice, a peeping voice, so I punched a hole because it was overdue. Normally, you can let it hatch on its own, but this one was kind of overdue. So at least it can breathe. I was so excited. I never had ducks hatching.
Okay, so we did like another hole so they can breathe. And they're actually talking to me. Yeah. Let's check the other ones.
Oh my god, so here you can clearly see the outline of the ducky. It's moving in there, hyperventilating. So I'm gonna punch a little hole. Maybe, I wonder if this is the beak and these are the legs. I'm not sure, but I'm gonna find some opening here. I'm gonna use this pointy hammer. It's disinfected already with alcohol. So here's my hole. And I'm gonna punch. Punch a little breathing hole. Oops. I wonder if I should go a little bigger. Alright, so I haven't finished it, but I just need to clean that place. So let's go inside. Lawnmower alfalfa here and see if you like it. Come on. I hope you're gonna have fun. You might. Need to be active. It's food.
Next, you're gonna see the duck's incubation temperature is around 99.5, so it's almost 100. But this incubator is not that accurate, so you're gonna see 100. Don't get scared. And pretty much 55% humidity.
Wow. These other two is just like whatever. We have time.
So this foam incubator is very inaccurate. I see the temperature swinging plus minus 4 or 5 degrees, which is not that good. I have to say for the ducks it was fine because they were hatching pretty strong. I almost hatched all of them out. I think only one died, but maybe one wasn't fertile. So it's pretty good. But yeah, this incubator is like maybe around $100 or something. So it's like the other one, the box GQF was around $1,000. So this is like 10 times cheaper. But you cannot incubate them together because these ducks require 55% humidity. And an ostrich requires like less than 20% humidity.
So this is how small a duck is compared to a hatched ostrich. Hatched ostrich there and the little duck.
Oh my goodness.
You wanna show yourself to the camera?
Yeah, you're a little stinker, but you're beautiful. You're gonna be beautiful.
Finally, they learned drinking. course, the smallest ones are still being dodo.
Is the proof that ducks love the water since birth, and they can play with the water for an hour if they want. She later can create quite a mess. Here you can see the orange plastic ties on their leg are the numbers. So this was necessary to identify right early when they hatch. You save the eggshell, the bloody membrane, actually not the shell, it's the bloody membrane of the egg, and you can send it to the lab to determine the sex, is it a male or female. But in order, of course, when you send like 10 or more samples to the lab, you have to identify them with numbers. Explain what's going on. So here I was trying to dry the umbilical cord. Unfortunately, it was bleeding a little too much. So I was trying to use the incubator's warm air to help drying. I didn't have a lot of space. Luckily, the ducks got along with the ostrich, or maybe I should say the other way around. The ostrich got along with the duck, and the ducks sometimes are very close being stepped on, unfortunately, because the ostriches are very clumsy, but they signal very super loud scream. So the ostriches pretty much learn not to try to even step, because the screaming was so annoying that comes from the ducks, and they never got hurt. So it's like, it's not that we were bleeding or any problem. No, they surprisingly got along well. Maybe later, when the ostrich really gets so much bigger, it takes them a while until they get smart, because they kind of dummies first. But as long as I kept them together, it was fine. You don't have to worry. But eventually, when an ostrich gets so much bigger, because they grow so much faster, you might want to separate them. And that's what I did later. So this is my response to Urban Rescue Ranch YouTuber. He said he never seen or haven't seen a lot of other YouTubers showing that these animals can get along. And yeah, I actually had them get along this summer. So yeah, it's just unfortunately so many of us farming or doing this stuff, but not a lot of us doing YouTube videos, not enough that you can show that these animals, when they babies, they can get along really well. Look at this sleepy. Oh no, he just got kicked in the face. So comfy. And got kicked in the face. It's not a nice thing to wake up like that. Oh my goodness, we got a Rhea baby. Look how cute she is! Goodness Lord! Wow, you're so beautiful and strong.
see it moving.
Oh, there's a baby inside. I had to watch carefully and go through the air pocket. Oh, it's a little toe. Where's the head? I'm afraid the head is on the other side. Oh, I think this is the neck. Yeah, I think this chick is male positioned. The head was supposed to be close to the air pocket, but the air pocket was all over the place, so. Hey, Booby, Booby, calm down, Booby. Okay, I cannot hold the phone. I think I can't. This baby ain't having it easy. The other one was strong enough to bust out the egg, but this one? Uh-oh. I kind of lost it. Where are you? Look at this double membrane. I knew it. This thing has double membrane. Oh, its head is there. Baby. Ooh, we got a baby. We got a baby here. So there's a double membrane here. hands are sanitized, but I'm working so much. They washed and sanitized, but I mean, I know it looks bad. But this is when you work outside a lot, it happens. Okay, so I was able to peel this one, the first membrane. And there's a second membrane under this. Oh! Okay, that one is already done. That looks like a beak already. Same day, and like you're bullying. The problem is, I cannot be here all the time. I have plenty of things to do. And the Ostrich snuggling. Sorry to wake you up, guys. I just had to show. Look at these pretty babies. Rhea babies. They are just so perfect and beautiful. You guys are beautiful. I love you too. Today, our instructor how to eat and drink is this ostrich, female, marked on the neck with red, and the Rhea is supposed to learn how to eat alfalfa, drink water. Oh, I think she's already doing it. She's gonna eventually learn. Such a baby. Such a Rhea baby. Another ostrich and three ducks in the background. Good news on the Rhea's. I just saw them eating and drinking. So the education camp is working. And the ostriches get along well so far. The ducks are sleeping in the corner. Hello. Hello, lovey. Sometimes they just start bolting, running real fast.
like a lightning bolt. They run fast. Call her Greenpeace. I marked her be green. She's peaceful. Yeah, she's very. I think it must be actually a female. Small one. The other one might be a male. We'll be lucky. And there's a third one, I don't know. We'll see. Look at that, the Rheas are learning. Hard to focus because the fans, but the Rheas actually eating with the ostriches from the chick starter. It's the first time I've seen that. It's amazing what more space can do. It's amazing that the little baby ostrich is active also over there. She's much more active. Same size as the Rhea, it's a little bit bigger of course, but she's much more active because she sees the big ones moving around.
Here I'm testing my ultimate safety setup for a power outage. It's a possible power outage. I mean, some farmers lost like thousands of dollars to power outage when you incubate. You're depending on the power, your success of incubation. So this Deltamax Pro can deliver 2,000 watts. You have to know that, because one incubator can consume up to 300 watts. And this is the connection to the generator right there. So it means that this can power an incubator for, let's say, 6 hours. Maybe I should say 7. And once this would run out, I mean, 7 hours is a long without power, but it happened to one of the farms when they had fire. And so once this runs out, the connection cable could trigger the gas generator. What was really interesting, that it wasn't triggering until it was down to 1%. And it was on 1% for some long time. You see, right now it's the 9% charge. And once it was on 1% for a long time again, it started that gas generator that's on the ground. And of course, everything has to be set up. That's a little bit of an issue because, this cable is thick copper. Of course, it cannot be wireless energy. Energy needs a lot of cable, but it needs to send the energy once it's down, and that would save you for a longer power outage. Okay, so it's nice, 9% charge. So when you see the 1018 as an input, now it jumped to 1022, 17. So that's the input that it receives. The amount of electricity it receives from the gas generator. So what you see now is the display of the gas generator, and it has 97% gas. It's enough to run it for 5 hours. And the Ecoflow Max, which has the battery only instead of gas, displays telling me that it has enough charge for 2 hours. It's 11% charged, and
oh my God.
And it was after the 4th of July. Whoa. So, you know how the neighbors do a lot of fireworks. I think the neighbors killed this poor animal. Maybe it had a heart attack. And, it's odd that it was after the 4th of July fireworks. And it's sad that one animal had to die because of explosives.
You dancing already? Temperature is perfect for brooding. It's close to the hatching temperature. Oh, are you looking at me now? Because you hear my voice. So upset. New environment? I suppose it's not that bad. It's like 86 degrees in here. Should be okay for now. At night, you guys go in the warm house. Okay? Under the light, it's even higher. 90.
In the next video, you're gonna see a leg problem fixed with regular tape, duct tape.
Yeah, baby had to be secured so those legs don't slip. Baby's doing much better now. Yeah, it doesn't always happen. It's not that often that that happens. All right, she learned how to walk with those leg ties. I mean, that's awesome that she even can stand, or he, or whatever. Yeah, no. It's already walking, so it worked out, because before the feet would slide apart, but not anymore. I'm super happy. The others didn't have any problem like that.
herd mentality. Are they coming back? Aren't they cute? Come on. Come on. He's the boss player. And the babies. That's so cute. Come on. Come on. Come on, you guys. Do the dance. Yeah. Get those dance moves. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. So cute. Look at them. In peace and love. Yeah, that's so cute. Ooh. You guys are so adorable. Just wanted to make a video shot. Notice how the one is not in the tub is breathing really hard because it's hot. Poor thing. She's getting the tub too. Are you hot? What's that on your lips? Stop it.
Come here. Come here. Come here. Come on. I know you want. I know you're curious.
The smallest baby and the biggest baby. The big one is only 5 times bigger. At least 4 times. What if I just look at the leg length? That was a dance. It's just maybe twice as big. But this is, the genes of this is closer to the black African. So cute. I mean African black. Ostrich.
After about 2 months, you can see their back at the height, at the middle 2x4 on the fence. Funny when they eat, it's like the bulging of the neck. I missed one, but they have a huge bulge. Maybe I can catch it now. Try to bite me. Oh,
now you're taller than 6 feet. You know, when you stretch, you get the bulge. Look at the bulging in the neck. Food goes down. That's funny. Oh my god. Hey, greedy pigs. Look at all the food. You stepping on the food. All right, let you guys eat. Some of you are crazy. Trying to run when I only do good things with you. So, and you have animals.
So this is what I call the flight control tape. It's a sticky tape you can get from Amazon. Kind of pricey because I think I spent $400 a month on this, considering how many flies. But it has a sticky surface, and you can even magnify its effect when you put the other nasty stuff, like the fly bait, the magnet, fly magnet bait on it, like sprinkle, because it has a smell.
Come on. Show that you can drink. Can you? Yeah. Yes, you can. Just making sure. So I have a drain, so I can clean it.
Good.
Thank you if you made it to the end of this video. I recorded this during the whole summer. I was just so busy, so insanely busy, that I didn't have time to publish. I was usually working 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock night by the time I finished cleaning, especially for the little ones, because the space is not that big, so I had to clean poop most of the time. And so apologize that I couldn't post the videos. I guess I just made it up now. Hope to see you soon. Bye-bye.